Yeah, it was obviously a tough one on Alistair. I mean, I think we can look back and Alistair got every opportunity to try and get himself on the plane to go there, and committed totally to that. He committed totally to, one, his own personal ambition and development as a player, but also to the teams, which I think all that work won't be lost. I think we've got a very good set of players, and Alistair, I think, understands that. And, you know, it's a tough decision. There's lots of tough decisions to go with sport. And, you know, it's time for us to move on, and also for Alistair to then refocus. He's got lots of test match cricket going to come up this year. You know, we've got a huge, he's got a huge role to play in that. And so he's got a clear focus over the next few months to get ready to prepare, both for himself and also for us as a team. It's a key relationship, but obviously Eoin's been with us now, and I've been coaching the one day side, and he's captained part of the time when Alice has not been available. So, and he's been very involved in all the sort of decisions anyway, because Alistair's close to Eoin and he's got a very good cricket brain. So I don't think so. I think it'd be exciting to work with Eoin. I think he'll bring a lot to the team. Very straightforward captain, I think, which will be a good thing for us. And very strong desire, I think, to go out there and show how well he can play, but also how well we can play as a team. Eoin's last trip to Australia, I think, for England, he had a fantastic time. He averaged 56, I think, or something like that, and did really well. So he'll know that form can vary. He'll be desperately keen to make sure that he fires as captain. I think our job is to support him in getting himself ready to play. That's the challenge for every player. They've got to go out there, and, you know, international cricket is about being judged as a player. That's what happens. What we do know is he's a fantastic one-day player. He has got a one-day mindset in how he goes about his cricket. And I think he'll certainly be up for the challenge. And I think, you know, he'll probably look back at the time he did captain in Sri Lanka and perform very well. Anybody who watched us bat in Sri Lanka, we saw people play a different style. We didn't always execute it perfectly because we got bowled out, but we scored at a quicker rate than Sri Lanka in most of the games. Well, we promoted Moeen Ali to bat the top of the order, who played a very aggressive brand of cricket at the top. We got two bowlers in the top five, which hasn't happened so much before. So we tried to create some flexibility. Yes, we moved our game. We didn't execute it always as well as we wanted to, but I think that change in mindset has already happened. I think with Eoin, he will drive that really hard, and I think that's a good thing. He plays his cricket like that. He wants to be aggressive, wants to look for positive opportunities, and I think that's something that everybody, both from the coaching and the playing staff, will embrace. The key now, in many ways for me, is that we've seen in Sri Lanka some good individual performances, but it's the team performance that counts now. We've got to perform well as a team. We've got to go there with a strong focus, one, to perform well in the tri-series, but really to get out there and, we're going to try and win the World Cup. Yeah. If we start to put those individual performances together within a team performance, we'll be a very dangerous side and we can beat anybody. I mean, that's part of the beauty of the World Cup, the way it's set up as a tournament. Any tournament player, you get on a roll and start playing well, you can do very well. And we've seen that in the past, I think, not just with England sides, maybe the 2020, but we've also seen it with other sides, India and whatever, when they've got on a roll in the tournament and gone on and carried on to win the tournament.